we spend 5 days away at a field study centre in North Somerset, studying ecology, which is the relationship between animals and plants and the environment that they live in. All the biologists go on that, and whilst we're away, we study marine biology, freshwater biology, terrestrial biology, and surprisingly, look at sand dunes as well. We stay in a centre owned by the Field Studies Council. It's a very old building. Parts of it date from 1599, but it does have electric light and heating. We're based there. There are classrooms there and there are laboratories there which we use. The general pattern of the day is we have about an hour in a classroom briefing and discussing what's going to be done. The Field Studies Council have specialist tutors who are experts in the area.
They actually like dry conditions, whereas the other snail species,
they're doing this sort of work all the time, so they're very familiar with the plants and animals and other creatures that are around us that we're studying.
Out on the rocks. Remember, that's where they all were.
Typically, we might leave the centre at 9 o'clock, arrive at the site 9:30, start the work after a short briefing at about 10, 10:15.
Really what we're looking at is a particular kind of habitat which is open.
And then the students work in small groups, pairs or threes.
We've been analysing the rock shore, like the organisms, invertebrates and the vertebrates, abiotic factors and biotic factors.
Right, but what's this? You met this yesterday. What's that?
One generation is haploid, one generation is diploid.
We started from the bottom since the tide was low. And we started analyzing every 5 meters with the method that it was called a vertical string. I don't remember, to be honest. We found around 8 or 9 different like invertebrates and plants, algae mainly. It is amazing to see how it changes like in every stage. Like at the beginning we found more invertebrates, but towards the end we found more algae and different kinds of it. So it's really nice to see how everything adapts to its own environment.
I found dog wells.
It is really exciting because it's not something we see in our own country. Mainly it's our first time, most of us, it's the first time we've been here, and it's like really nice.
That's a good question there.
The field trip features very much as the high point of the course. It's probably the most favourite thing that they actually do. They thoroughly enjoy it. It also brings them together as a group, and I think they enjoy that very much as well.
I believe this field trip has been a great experience, not only because we got to interact between each other more, but we've learned a lot, and the workload is a lot, but it's worth it.